Today's video is going to be a little bit technical, very geeky, but I'm about to show you something that is going to absolutely blow your mind if you're a Fujifilm Lightroom user. Let's get started. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. Now when Fujifilm releases a brand new camera, they sometimes include a brand new film simulation for that specific camera. For example, when the X-T4 was released, they included the new bleach bypass film simulation. And that's great if you're an owner of an X-T4, but what about if you have an X-T3 or an X-T2? In those cases, you can only use the film simulations that are included with your camera. This same restriction also applies when you open up a Fujifilm RAW file in either Lightroom or Capture One. In both these programs, they will look at the metadata contained in your RAW file, and then based upon what camera model they see, they will only allow you to apply film simulations for that specific camera model. So for example, I shot this photo on a Fujifilm X-T4 camera, and if I go into my profiles, look at all the film simulations I could use. However, here is a photo I shot on the Fujifilm X-T3 camera, but when I go into the film simulation list, have a look at this. Bleach bypass is missing. There are more film simulations available for the X-T4 file than the X-T3 file. Now, there have been photography channel YouTube videos with workarounds to try and get around this restriction. The most common is to edit the RAW file's EXIF data before importing it into Lightroom and Capture One. The problem is, that's kind of a hassle because you have to do that every single time you want to edit and manipulate one of your photos. Until today. I think I discovered a way to make a setting change in Lightroom that will allow all film simulations to work, whether you're using an X-T2, X-T3, or an X-T4 camera. Frankly, they might work in other Fujifilm cameras as well. I just haven't tested them yet. Now, before I show you how to do this, I need you to listen very carefully to what I'm about to tell you. I'm going to show you how to edit a file that both Apple and Adobe probably don't want you monkeying around too much with. Therefore, it's quite possible that if you make a mistake, or if there's a new version of Lightroom released, that things could break. And in that case, it is also possible that the only way you could recover everything is to reinstall Lightroom from scratch. Therefore, this video and what I'm about to tell you is designed for you to do for fun. I am taking no responsibility if you screw up your copy of Lightroom, you screw up your computer, or you screw up your life, okay? Got that? Got that? Good. Let me show you how to do this. First of all, this technique will only work on a Mac. I have not yet had the time to figure out how to do it on Windows. The first thing you need to do is download a copy of Visual Studio Code for the Mac. I will have a link to download it in the description of this video. It's a free app and it's awesome. It's a text editor and it allows you to edit what we're going to need to edit in a few minutes. Once you have Visual Studio Code downloaded and opened, it'll sort of look like this, a very boring window. What you want to do is go to your Finder and look for your Macintosh hard drive, Macintosh HD. That's the outermost drive, sort of the root drive on your computer. Once you're in your Macintosh hard drive, go into your Applications folder. So basically, you need to get to your Applications folder in Finder. Now that I'm in Finder, you'll see Adobe Lightroom Classic. Go ahead and expand that, and you'll have two choices. One is to uninstall it, the other is Adobe Lightroom Classic app. Do not double-click on that because that will just open up Lightroom and that's not what we want to do here. What you want to do is you want to right click it where it says show package contents. So use the mouse, right click it, and this is what you get. So once you're in here, what you want to do is you want to go into resources. See that folder? Go into resources and then look for a folder called settings. There it is right here. Go into settings, then go into Adobe, go into profiles, go into camera, go into Fujifilm. You're looking for the X-T4 folder. You see that right there? Now, the first thing you need to do to cover yourself is to make a copy of it and put it aside. This way, in case you screw anything up, you can always just put it back. Right click that, say copy, and put it somewhere safe. I'm just gonna put it now, okay? I put it right here, and I'm just gonna call this, you know, emergency backup or something. All right, that way I could recover those files if something bad happens, or I'd have to reinstall Lightroom. So now you go inside XT4 and there they are, bleach bypass, classic negative, camera sepia. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna make an edit to each of these three files. Very simple, and we're gonna use Visual Studio Code to do that. You can do this. Here we go. Bleach bypass. I'm going to drag the file and drop it in there. And there's all this gobbledygook. If you see a little thing pop up, just click X to close it out right there. Okay. Now look for, it's on line 15 and it says camera model restriction, right? You see that? Fujifilm XT4. What you want to do is get rid of Fujifilm XT4. Okay, so that you just have two quotation marks. You have to have the quotation marks. So basically it'll say camera mode restriction and then two quotation marks with nothing between it. Then go ahead and save this. You can go to File, Save. Now, very important, you're gonna have this thing pop up here that says insufficient permissions. Click on Retry as Sudo. Don't ask what that gobbledygook means, but just do it. Click on Retry as Sudo. Boom, and then it's gonna ask for the password for your computer. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that in, and now it's saved the file. Click X to close it out right here. Let's do the next one. Classic negative, boom. Let's erase Fujifilm XT4 for the camera mode restriction. I'm gonna go ahead, file, save. Retry as sudo, you gotta do that. Put in your password, okay. And I'm gonna do the last one, the sepia. Okay, all done. You can close Visual Studio, you don't need it anymore. What we have done here is we have edited these three files. These are XMP files, which is basically files that tell Lightroom some information about what to do and not do with these film simulations. Okay, now we're back in Lightroom. Now, I'm gonna go to this one right here, Fujifilm XT3. I'm gonna go right here, have a look at this. Bleach bypass, classic negative. Sepia. If I choose bleach bypass, boom, bleach bypass. Here it is with classic negative. Here it is with sepia. Have a look at that. And what I did for fun was I took a JPEG that I applied bleach bypass in the XT4. So here they are compared. Check this out. The photo on the left is the JPEG straight out of camera from the XT4. The photo on the right is the raw file from the XT3 with the bleach bypass film simulation added. Let's try an XT2 raw file. I love this photo. I shot this a few years ago. This is the first photo in the history of the world that has an Atlanta police officer, Deadpool character, and Hello Kitty in the same frame. How awesome is that? I'm gonna go ahead and write in here and click on, for example, classic negative. There it is, classic negative on an XT2 RAW file in Lightroom. Is Pal the Tech a great channel or what? Now keep in mind, this was and is a hack. I don't know if there are other things that are being done to the photos by Lightroom that are missing here by doing it this way. I don't know if this will break with a future update to Lightroom. I don't know, I don't know, I don't know. If you wanna put things back and you've come to this video now because you've screwed it up and you wanna put things back to how they were, all you need to do is recover from your backup. Oh, don't have a backup. Didn't save backups, huh? Okay, then what you need to probably do at this point is the files that you edited, you can put them back very, very easily. Open them up, the ones that you've already edited. Look for camera model restriction. Go between the quotations right there and paste in Fujifilm XT4. Remember to retry as sudo when you save these. Put in your password and you can go ahead and put them back in that exact same way. Okay, just re-edited them back. There we go. Now when I open Lightroom back up, things should be back to normal. Okay, I'm back at Deadpool. Now look at how it said camera classic negative. That's because I had applied it under the hack. But when I reopen that file, I can still see that sort of illegal film sim added. It's when I go to change it. See, now it's gone from this menu. So if I change it to classic Chrome, say, Now, if I go back, I can't put it back to what it was. So it's sort of a one-way ticket. I will have some information and resources in the description down below. I'll have a link to download Visual Studio Code. I will have a mention of the path that you need to take to get to the area on the Mac to edit those files. I will say this again. Please do not do this hack with your client work. I don't know the potential of this. I don't know how far down the rabbit hole this can go. I'd like to come up with a Windows version for this, but in the meantime, if you have a Mac, give it a shot. I think you'll find it's a lot of fun. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe, and I will see you in another video again real soon. Take care.